Savior of the Village. Once upon a time, there lived a poor farmer in a village. He did not have land of his own. Hence, he used to work in others' farms. He used to get to work early in the morning and used to come back by late evening when it was dark. He had two kids. His wife was unwell and was also taking care of an orphan from his relatives. He was only earning member and had to feed five people in the family. Due to lack of money, he was not even able to provide medical treatment to his wife. It was very difficult for him to earn for basic living and hence had no money to treat his wife. Nearby the village, there was a dark jungle, and in the jungle, there was a temple of ancient times. In the temple, there lived a monk, and he was very famous. He was very famous all over for his accomplishments. Everyone in the village used to respect him a lot. People used to participate with a lot of enthusiasm in the prayers conducted in the temple. The farmer also used to respect the monk, but he never used to get time to go for the prayers. After the hard work of the whole day, he used to go off to sleep in no time and used to get up directly in the morning and used to leave early for work in the morning. He always used to feel bad that he was not able to take time for the prayers. He always used to think that this birth has already gone in vain. And is my next birth as well going to be in the same way? Many years passed doing the same routine. Farmer was old now and was not able to work in the farm. However, had no choice because he had to take the responsibility of the entire family on his shoulders. Once, it was continuously raining heavily for many days together, and the river near the village was almost flooded. One day, the edge of the river broke and the water came inside the village. All the villagers went running to the monk asking for help and told the monk,
"Sir, can you please help us come out of this flood? Our village is drowning. If this continues, then all our animals will drown. Our farms, our grains, everything will get ruined. We all will be finished. Please help us."
Monk was very confident about his knowledge and his accomplishments. But when he reached close to the river, he saw that the farmer was putting mud on the broken side of the river. It was raining very heavily, but the farmer was just not worried about anything, and he was just engrossed in repairing the river with complete dedication. Monk was surprised to see this. Monk was highly knowledgeable, but he did not have the guts to work in such difficult conditions, and that too with so much of dedication to repair the broken river. Monk thought, "This simple looking farmer is certainly a very big man." He told the villagers to help the farmer and quietly left from there. However, he was not getting peace at all. He kept recollecting the dedicated farmer again and again. Next day, early in the morning, he got up and went near the river where it was broken. He saw the villagers had worked hard together and had taken the situation under control. The monk's eyes kept searching for the farmer, and finally he saw him sitting in the corner. The farmer was worried that if the situation goes out of control, then all the villagers will fall in trouble, and hence he sat in that corner for the entire night. He did not sleep even for a minute. When he saw the monk, he fell into his feet. To this, monk took him in his arms and said,
What are you doing this? I'm watching you since years now. And you are the only one person who never visited my temple.
Farmer folded his hands and said,
I could not do anything in my life. Neither I gave charity, nor I could do prayers. I wasted my entire life just like that. Please forgive me.
To this, monk said,
You are already an accomplished man, and even more than me. I'm sure you have done a lot of meditation in life.
To this the farmer laughed and said,
What meditation are you talking about, sir? I have not done anything, neither I have any knowledge. I am just a simple farmer. I have always taken all my work and situation as a word of God and have always done my work with complete dedication.
While he was saying this, his face had some unusual glow. The monk saw him very closely. He felt as if he had seen God in the face of the farmer. The monk greeted him with his folded hands and quietly left from there.